Hello and welcome to the second edition of Nunnery News on YouTube. With so much going on this half term, we've condensed just some of the incredible events taking place here at Nunnery. Join me, Lauren Roberts.
And me, Lottie Hammond.
As we look over the past half term.
On the 2nd of February, students from all years took part in the annual UK Math Challenge, a voluntary national challenge designed to test problem solving and mathematical skills. We are yet to receive the results. We wish all of the contestants luck. Bronze, silver and gold certificates will be awarded to all of those who achieve a certain score.
This term, the Parliament has been busy. As with every half term, two representatives from each form group in each year attend a session in which issues of the year group and form are debated and resolved. However, this term a new initiative of duty teams and duty prefects was introduced in order to keep the corridors clean and happy.
It's that time again. The incredible dancers in Nunnery Wood put on yet another dazzling display for both staff and students, wowing the audience with their talent. From ballet to singing, the dance show truly had it all. It's been a hell of a ride, driving the edge of a night. Never let you go, never let me down. Don't you give up, nah, nah, nah. I won't give up, nah, nah, nah. Let me love you, let me love you. Don't you give up, nah, nah, nah. I won't give up, nah, nah, nah. Let me love you, let me love you.
The performance of this year's school play, DNA, edges ever closer as our hard-working cast rehearses and prepares. Twice a week, the cast have been rehearsing Dennis Kelly's DNA and proving their dramatic credentials to all. Directed by Mr. Burford and co-directed by Anissa Westbury, DNA takes the audience through eerie, jolly and macabre scenes of horror and excitement as the cast of teenagers find their feet in an ever-changing and dangerous world, covering their footprints wherever they can. We look forward to the upcoming DNA performances and good luck and well done to everyone involved.
The annual Nunnery Chess Tournament has just finished. Once again, the great battle took place in the library to see who would be crowned Nunnery Wood Chess Winner 2016. The winner was Jacob Aldridge in Year 11, who out of 32 competitors emerged victorious. His runner-up was the equally good Daniel Brandt, who was knocked out by Jacob. Each player fought for a place in the final, and although 30 of them did not make it to the final, we must congratulate the superb effort that they put into the competition. This is an annual event, so if next year you want to compete for the much coveted title of Nunnery Wood Chess Winner, then sign up now.
On Tuesday the 24th of January, the school hosted another SMSE Day. With the focus on careers, education after school, and what decisions we should make, students attended careers fairs, watched presentations, and took part in quizzes to see what career would float their boat. On this interesting and important day, Nunnery students were proud and honoured to host visitors from magistrates' courts in Selfie, who talked to students about their jobs and what life is like for them. On the whole, students enjoyed the day, from picking up booklets and sweets from the careers fair to being part of a crime scene at the dance blog, which we are pleased to say was a fake one. We hope the SMSE Day helped everyone to find out what career and life plan suited them best.
Year 9 students have been busy selecting their GCSE options. They have been well prepared for this through assemblies and options evening and subject teachers setting aside time to discuss courses. Students have been placed on different pathways to help ensure that they make the wise choice.
On the 27th of January, the school came together to mark the annual Holocaust Memorial Day. In memory of those affected by past and present genocides, assemblies and talks were given about how genocide begins and how it causes tragedy. To mark the occasion, Miss Beachley and the head boy and girl, Josh Cochran and Ella Sutton, attended a memorial service at County Hall in honour of those who were victims of genocide and the Holocaust, taking part in readings and performances from five other schools. This was shown on BBC Midlands Today. In history classes, all Key Stage 3 students spent time looking at Holocaust and other genocides.
The Arts Year 10 students are well underway in their GCSE courses in Art and Drama, and we were delighted to be able to watch them at work.
Throughout January, Year 10 and 11 have been taking part in their mock exams. For some, the exams are briefly over, but the behaviour and confidence shown by our Year 10s and 11s was inspiring, and we wish everyone who took part in the exams well. So fingers crossed for their results.
The sports, clubs and teams have been busy again throughout the term. The cross-country running team have made it through to the regional finals. The Year 8 basketball team have bounced back under the guidance of Mr. Brogan to win matches against local rivals Bishop Perrone with a score of 50-12. The girls' Year 8 football team recently achieved a 5-4 victory over Glamorgan Valleys, and the Year 7 and 8 rugby girls secured a comfortable 80-20 win over Sibford School. The Key Stage 4 badminton team won the county round of National Schools Badminton Championships, which is an amazing achievement. Meanwhile, the Year 10 hockey team secured 2 wins over George Salter School and King's Gloucester. Year 11 judo player Sean Brabosca gained a silver medal at the English Open Championship despite having an injured knee. Well, that concludes our broadcast for this off term. Thank you for listening and be sure to subscribe for next time.
Oh my God.